Hello, welcome back to my world of fragrance. Hopefully you can hear me a lot better in this video. I do have a new mic, as some of you may have seen in my last video. So hopefully this works. Today I'm reviewing Womanity by Thierry Mugler. This is a purchase that was a blind buy for me many years ago. And I was living in a place where I didn't really have access to any good perfumes. Everyone kind of wore all of the same perfumes. Everyone's clothing was gray, fragrances were gray. And so I was looking for something that was out of the ordinary and that I could also afford at the time. So I found Womanity after reading lots and lots of reviews, and this was just, you know, the bottle was the first thing that struck me, of course. But I do think that this is a fragrance that is worthy of a review before I get rid of it. So Womanity was created in 2010 by two male perfumers, as well as the company Maine. And so much thought went into creating this fragrance. This was released 5 years after Alien was released, which, as you know, was a massive success. And so Alien was kind of, you know, extraterrestrial, whereas Womanity was meant to bring us back to Earth. Womanity was meant to be a reflection of all of the various expressions of womankind. The connectivity between women, symbolized by the chain and the ring on the bottle. And this is a fragrance that plays on those different contrasting elements. So it is sweet, yet it's savory. It is woody, yet it's airy. It is masculine, yet it is feminine. And if you really cut to the chase, this smells like feminine secretions. We're all adults here, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that natural smell. It's the reason why you are here today. There's something called dabbing, which is actually where you take the feminine juices and dab them in different areas wherever you'd like and use that as a sort of perfume. So this helps you attract your partner, and it also empowers you as a woman in general. I have not tried the dabbing, but it is an actual thing. It's very modern to try to completely erase all traces of your natural scent, and that shouldn't necessarily be the goal. At the end of the day, when you're intimate with someone in whatever way, shape, or form, then it should be an honor for you to actually get to smell their natural scent. I mean, I know my mother by the perfume that she wears, but this is also in combination with her natural smell that, you know, when those two elements come together, you create magic. And that's the beauty of perfume that works. It becomes the wearer. It's not so obviously worn. So back to Womanity, the reason why we're parting ways is that I simply don't identify with this fragrance. It is a fragrance that, you know, because of its many contradictions, is hard to pinpoint. It is fruity and juicy from the fig, yet there is fig leaf as well that lends this woodiness to the fragrance. And then overall, there is a salty vibe. So for me, this falls into the category of an aquatic fragrance, which is not necessarily one of my favorite categories. The lasting power of this fragrance is great. I also get a moderate sillage, which is wonderful. I could imagine someone wearing this at the seaside. This is actually stunning with salty air helping to uplift that Womanity waft that you get from the fragrance. But I have been holding on to the bottle because it sort of is somewhat of a jewel in my collection. And it reminds me of that time in my life where I was trying to discover my taste in fragrance, how I would express myself through fragrance, etc. I do think that this is a fragrance that everyone should try to give a sniff, if not for anything but to be reminded of the multifacetedness, the different expressions of what we call a woman. And should I ever want to smell like feminine secretion, well, I know where to find it. I hope you enjoyed today's review. Do let me know your thoughts on Womanity. Is this a fragrance that you have smelled before? Do you love her? Do you hate her? And I will see you in my next review.